Hey, what is going on, guys? I'm Zed Stealth here, and in today's video, we're going to be taking a look at around 15 mistakes that low elo AD carries make. And then also, I am doing a giveaway right now for the new Pretty Kitty Rengar skin because I'm part of the League Partner Program. I was given a bunch of codes to give away for the skin, so I am doing that giveaway over on my Discord server. I'm also doing another giveaway on Twitter, so check both those out. The links will be down in the description if you guys are interested. So to start off here, number one is that a lot of AD carries do not play out of enemy CC range when their support is not in lane with them. It's super important that if your support is not with you in lane, that you just back off, you don't go up too close, and you miss a few CS. It's fine to miss a few CS when your support's either walking back to lane or he's roaming, but you just have to do your best to not die when your support is not there. So many times, AD carries will just end up greeting for CS when their support isn't there. They'll die in the laning phase and then they pretty much just throw the game. So just pay attention to where your support is on the map. If he's not with you in lane, then you do have to play safer and you do have to play accordingly. So number two has to do with the level two all in and the level two spike, and that's a lot of players don't really play around it enough or they don't respect it enough in the laning phase. So if you're playing with a good CC support champion, say you're playing something like Lucian and your support's playing Braum, you guys got a really, really good level two all in. So you can just let your Braum know that let's try to go for the level two all in, try to continuously auto attack the minions, get the level two before the opponent, and then look to go for a quick kill. If you don't know, you're gonna hit level two off of the first full wave and then three melee minions on the second wave. So after a while, you can kind of just know when you're gonna hit level two. But if you don't know right now, then that's how you can kind of judge when you're gonna be able to hit level two. So either play aggro or back off depending on the strength of your level two. So if the enemy team does have a very good level two all in, but yours is not very good, or if the enemy is gonna hit the level two before you do, then just make sure you're respect it, make sure you back off, just let the wave crash into you and don't end up dying to level two if the enemies is stronger. So number three is that a lot of AD carries don't really think about what they're doing with the minion wave during the laning phase. So depending on the matchup, depending on how the game is going to influence whether you want to shove the wave into the enemy's tower, whether you want to try to keep it in the middle or try to get a freeze. And it's really gonna depend on every single game and it's gonna change with every single game. But I do have a bunch of different situations up on screen here that should almost happen every single game that you can use most of the time. So if you don't have kill pressure in lane, but you do have the shove advantage, for example, if you're playing something like Sivir and Janna, you guys don't really have a ton of 2v2 kill pressure. It's not like if you hit a Janna W, you're just instantly gonna kill the opponent. So you can still look to shove in that lane though. You do have good shove with the Sivir, so you can look to shove the enemy into tower and you can get turret plating. And a lot of the time, just getting turret plating is even better than getting a kill. Now, if you do not know where the enemy jungler is on the map, or if you don't have any good vision for yourself down in the river, then it's almost always best to just keep the wave in the middle or try to get a freeze closer to your tower. If you do shove the enemy into their tower and you don't have any vision, then you're just super vulnerable for a gank. And if you don't have your flash up especially, or if you don't have a gap closer on the AD carry you're playing, it makes it even more risky. So a lot of the time, if you are playing a champion with a gap closer and you still do have your flash up, then it's not too risky for you to shove all the way up to the enemy's tower if you don't have vision. But most of the time, it's just best not to shove too far if you do not have the vision to do so. Now, if you do have an aggressive support though, something like a Leona, Blitz, or a Thresh, then you don't really want to be shoving the enemy into their tower. If you do get a lead in lane, and if you do have some really good kill pressure, you want to try to keep the wave in the middle of the lane or keep it on your side of the lane, and then just look to zone the enemy from a CS. If they walk up too close and they try to get CS, then you can look to punish that and get a lot of free kills in lane by doing that. So number four is that a lot of AD carries don't play around large minion waves to win trades or to punish enemies for being over aggressive. So if you do have a large minion wave built up, then you should be looking to play aggressive, especially in the first few levels, because minion waves are gonna deal a ton of damage. If the enemy tries to trade into you, into that large minion wave, you're gonna win almost every single time. And then vice versa, if the enemy minion wave is really large, you gotta make sure that you do not end up greeting for like one or two CS and end up dying dying for it, because if you end up losing a large minion wave in the early game, then you're just gonna fall super far behind in XP and in gold. So you just wanna play safe. If the enemy wave is large, let it crash into you, because if it is bigger than yours, it will eventually crash into your tower. So don't die by greeding for one CS in that large wave. So number five is that most AD carries are just gonna farm side waves, or they're just gonna farm waves that aren't really safe to do so in the mid to late game. When you're playing AD carry in the mid to late game, you wanna be farming the wave that's safest for you. So you always wanna be trying to stay with your support. You wanna be trying to stay with your team, and you don't wanna be the one that's taking like bot farm 25 to 30 minutes into the game. That's when Baron's gonna be up as well. So you want to have your top laner down bot lane with the teleport if you can. You wanna be farming mid wave or top lane wave when that Baron is up. So just make sure that you're farming waves that are safe to do so, and also farming waves that are gonna keep you in a position that you're able to contest objectives. So number six is that most AD carries don't try to lane swap with their top laner after they take bot tower. Now, obviously this is not gonna work out every single game, and your top laner in lower elo is not gonna understand every single game what a lane swap is and what the point of it is. So he's just gonna stay top lane and he's not gonna listen to you. So if that does happen, obviously just go back down bot lane and continue farming your bot wave. But if you do get bot lane tower, you let your top laner know that you can swap, and he goes bot lane, you and your support go top lane, then it just allows you to keep tempo up in the early game. You continue to keep getting gold from towers, because if you send two members top lane and the enemy top laner is there by himself, then you're gonna be able to easily get some tower damage off, get that tower, and just continue to snowball your lead in the early game. So if you can do this, if your top laner is understanding of the situation, then look to take advantage of it, because it is gonna help you snowball games a lot better. One situation where it wouldn't be very good to swap is that if a dragon is just coming up, then I would still recommend staying bot in that situation. But if you've just taken a dragon, or if a dragon's not coming up for a couple minutes, then it is still good to swap in that situation. So number seven is that a lot of AD carries don't use their heal or flash quick enough in the laning phase when they're playing against a really aggro bot lane. So for example, what you see a lot of the time is that your support will get engaged on by the enemy support, and then the AD carry is gonna save heal until the very end, until like they're very low on HP. But a lot of the time, what you wanna do when you're using your heal in the laning phase is you wanna use it as quick as possible if the enemy is gonna be going for an all-in on you. If the enemy support drops the ignite on you, or on your support, and you haven't healed yet, then your heal is gonna heal you for a lot less because of the ignite. It's gonna reduce the healing effect. So if you're getting all in, just healing early a lot of the time is gonna be better in that situation. And also, you gotta think about, like, if the enemy does have a lot of hard chain, and you also gotta think about during the laning phase and throughout the game, if the enemy team does have a lot of good chain crowd control, like if they hit one CC ability, will they be able to hit another and then another after that? If that's the case, then you do have to be paying attention, and you do have to be flashing early in those situations, because even though you might think that if you get hit by one CC ability, you can just flash after that, but oftentimes it's not the case. And if you get hit by one CC ability, multiple follow-up after, and you just die immediately. So number eight is that a lot of AD carries don't know where to position in the laning phase when they're shoved under tower. So you almost never want to be positioning in between the right side wall and your tower. The reason for this is because it's a very narrow area, and it makes it very easy for the enemy team to line up a skill shot on you. If the enemy is playing like a hook champion especially, you never want to be standing in between the right side wall and your tower, because you're going to get hit by the hook every single time. So you want to be standing in between the left side wall and your tower, because that's going to give you more room to dodge skill shots. It's also where the minion wave is going to be, so you can stand behind your minion wave, and it's just going to be a lot easier for you to just not get hit by skill shots in the laning phase. So number 9 is that most AD carries don't adjust their playstyle based on who they're playing with or how the lane is going. So one thing you should look to do every single game when you're playing AD carry is that just take a look at your mastery score on your support. You can do this in the loading screen. You just click on your support, take a look at their mastery score. If they have a very low mastery score or if it's 0 and they've never played the support before, then you do have to adjust your playstyle based on that information. Chances are if they've never played the champion, they're not going to know what to do, so you should not expect to be playing aggressive in that lane. You should just try to do your best to farm and don't really expect to be going for these crazy all-ins or anything. Also, if you do die once in the laning phase, then don't continue to play aggro in the lane. You're going to just throw the lane even more. You're going to fall even further behind, so just try to wait for a jungle gank. Try to continue to farm up because a lot of the time, games are very winnable, even if you just die once in the laning phase and if you continue to farm. But if you die multiple times after that, then it just makes the game very, very hard to win. And then number 10 is that most AD carries just default to going Berserker Greaves every single game. And I think that going for Ninja Tabbies and going for Merc Treads on AD carries are very underrated, and you should be going them depending on a couple of different situations. So if the enemy team comp does have a lot of ability power, they also have a lot of hard crowd control, I would go Merc Treads every game in that situation. The value you get out of the Merc Treads against a full AP comp and against a hard crowd control comp is really good. Also, if the enemy team does have a full AD comp, then I would go for Ninja Tabbies every single time in that situation. The times where I would go Berserker Greaves is that if you're snowballing in the early game, if the enemy team comp doesn't really have a lot of threats on their team that can really assassinate you, but if the enemy team does have a couple fed assassins on their team, then going for defensive boots is almost always better in those situations. So number 11 is that most AD carries don't know who to focus in team fight. Should they be focusing the carries on the enemy team? Should they be focusing the tanks? Well, it all depends pretty much on who's closest to you. 99% of the time, you should be focusing the enemy that is closest to you. So if there's a enemy Cho'Gath right on top of you, then obviously be trying to kite away from him, focus him down. Don't be trying to ignore that Cho'Gath and be trying to hit the enemy AD carry on the enemy team. It's always going to be best for you to just try to kite back, hit who's in front of you. If your team is flaming you and they're telling you to stop focusing the tanks when they're right on top of you and when they're killing you, then you have my permission to flame them in that situation, because you should always be trying to kite back and just focus the enemy that is closest to you. Now, there is an exception to this, and in a very low percent of your games, if you do have the ability to flash forward or you do have the ability to dash forward and take out the enemy carry who's pretty much the whole enemy team, if you can do that and if you trade your life for the enemy carry and it means that your team is going to be able to win the fight after that, then in those situations it's fine to do that. But if you're flashing forward on an AD carry, if you're playing super aggressive, then chances are you're going to die in team fights and you're not going to be very useful for your team. So you should be just trying to sit back, peel for yourself, trying to hit the closest member to you, and you're just going to win a lot more games if you do that. So number 12 is that most AD carries don't pay attention to enemy cooldowns before entering a team fight. If the enemy team comp does have something like a Hecarim, a Malphite, if they have these really good hard engaged champions, then you have to do your best to stay out of the fight until those cooldowns are blown. Now, it's always going to depend on what kind of CC the enemy has and what kind of comp they have as to when you're going to be able to enter the fight as an AD carry, but if they do have long range crowd control abilities, then you want to be staying back, you want to be playing safe until those cooldowns are blown, because oftentimes just staying alive as an AD carry is better than actually doing damage. If you're sitting back and playing safe and the enemy is not able to find an engage on you, then eventually they will engage on one of your teammates. They'll waste their cooldown on one of your teammates, and that's when you can look to jump and that's when you can look to enter the fight. So just always trying to be paying attention to what high priority CC abilities the enemy does have up, and then when they're down, look to take advantage of that in a team fight. So number 13 also has to do with mid to late game team fighting, and that is most AD carries will waste their flash in mid to late game fights for kills that don't net them anything. So in the mid to late game, you almost always want to be saving your flash to live instead of to kill. If you're flashing to kill in the mid to late game, you want to make sure that it's leading to an objective or it's leading to you winning the game, because if you're flashing to kill and you don't get anything out of it, just the kill alone is not worth your flash in the mid to late game, especially when you're playing AD carry. Having your flash up as an AD carry is very important, so you always gotta be thinking about, before you flash for that kill, what's it gonna net you? Because if it doesn't net you anything, then you don't want to be using it. So number 14 is that most AD carries don't play around low HP minions in lane to win trade. So this is really important to do. And if your minions are low on HP and the enemy is gonna go in to auto attack to get the CS, this is the perfect time for you to look to trade, because during the enemy's auto attack animation, he's obviously not gonna be able to attack you. So you're gonna get a free auto attack off on him. Also during his auto attack animation, he isn't gonna be able to move. So this is a really good time for you to look to land a skill shot on the opponent. So if you are playing an AD carry who does have a little bit harder of a skill shot to land, then when they're going for low HP minions, this is the perfect time for you to look to hit them with. Number 15 is that most AD carries don't buy a stopwatch in the mid to late game, and they really undervalue the strength of the stopwatch. So in the mid to late game, if you've already got a couple items on your AD carry and the reason to why you've been dying the past couple of fights is because you've just got bursted out right away, or if it's because the enemy has just been diving onto you and you haven't been able to do anything, then grabbing a stopwatch, just sitting on that stopwatch, having it in your inventory, is not only going to mean that the enemy is going to be less likely to dive onto you now because you're going to have that stopwatch, but it also means that if they do dive onto you, you're going to be able to use that and you're going to be able to allow your team to reposition and help heal for you. So I think AD carries and lower elos really undervalue the stopwatch. So even if you don't have enough money for Guardian Angel, or even if you can't finish your Guardian Angel right away, grabbing a stopwatch is still not a bad idea at all. So that is going to be it for this video, guys. Those were 15 common mistakes that low elo AD carries make. So if you guys did enjoy this video, then be sure to drop a like and subscribe if you've yet to already. So thanks for watching, have an awesome day, and I will see you in my next video.